While the general election is just under 4 months away, early November, some key issues are on voters' minds, including sending children back to school on time in September, in-person classes, that is. And One America's Stefan Kleinhenz caught up with Bill Hagerty, who's running for a Senate seat in Tennessee.
All right, I'm joined again by Bill Hagerty, running for the U.S. Senate in Tennessee. Bill, you've been endorsed by President Trump. You're working on his economic task force. There's a lot going on right now. Big question going through the news cycle is, are we going back to school in the fall? Your perspective on everything going on, and is it an important issue? Do students need to be back in the classroom come September?
It's a very important issue, Stefan. And, you know, right here in Nashville, Tennessee, the mayor's just announced that we're going to be only online in the beginning of the school year. I think that's going to be a sad situation for students here in Tennessee. It's really been proven that online education is far inferior to the classroom. And right here in Tennessee, it creates a huge problem for those kids that don't have access to broadband. That's a significant issue for our rural citizens. So this is a problem that's got to be resolved. I think it's not a question of when we go back to school. It's a question of how we do it. And in my mind, we do it safely, but we need to get kids back to school. We're going to lose a generational, we're going to have a generational impact here because of the impact of this backsliding in the educational product for our younger children. But we also have a big societal issue, too. Sorry, that there are a lot of kids here that really depend on schools for a nutritious meal. It's a safe environment, and some of our kids don't have that at home during the daytime. And frankly, there's a lot of mentoring that goes on at school that's important. And then finally, from an economic standpoint, if children don't go back to school, there are many parents who are unemployed today that can't work from home that are going to stay unemployed. Think about the hospitality industry, the tourism industry, restaurants. Those people don't have the ability to work from home remotely. If their children can't go back to school, they're not going back to work, and that's going to have a significant economic impact too.
So grammar school is part of this, but we're also looking at some universities, big universities like Harvard, saying they're going online as well. We know the president has been vocal on that. You know, you're out there in Tennessee. That's some SEC football. You think we're going to see a football season? You think we're going to see some of these big universities follow suit with schools like Harvard?
I know right here at University of Tennessee, the goal is to have our teams back on the gridiron. I'm not sure how they're going to manage the flow. They're still working on it right now. The flow of visitors and the patrons that want to be there. But the fans here in Tennessee want to see football, and they want to be back on the gridiron, and they want to be back in the stadium. So we'll figure that out.
So, Bill, we're about 4 months away from the general election. We know the president obviously up for re-election. You're facing, hopefully, going to be in the general election there for the state of Tennessee. We've seen riots and protests all across the country. How do you think that going into an election, that the issues we're seeing right now are going to affect the election, and how are people in Tennessee and across the country feeling about these riots and calls to defund the police?
I think it's going to have a significant impact, Stefan. And when I talk to people all across Tennessee, they're very concerned. I mean, essentially, our nation is at a crossroads. Do we want to allow the angry mob to push us off the cliff into socialism? Or are we going to stand up for what makes this nation great? Our freedoms, our opportunities, our liberties are at stake right now. And what I think you'll see come Election Day is the silent majority come roaring back, because we cannot let the angry mob dictate American society. We can't have the cancel culture come in and destroy people's businesses and people's lives and ruin our history. I think Americans are going to stand up against this, because this is definitely not the direction that the people I talk with in Tennessee want to see us moving.
Well, Bill, we saw the president reaffirm his support and full endorsement for your race there in Tennessee. Best of luck to you, and always good to see you.
Great to be with you again, Stefan. Thanks so much.
Want to see more videos like this? Click on the link below and subscribe to One America News on YouTube, and call your cable provider and kindly demand that One America News is added to your lineup. Call and subscribe today.